ACL reconstruction can be performed in a variety of ways. Let's go over the anatomy so that we're clear on what our terms are. This is the knee joint, this is the femur, this is the tibia, and this is the patella or kneecap and the patellar tendon. So the ACL is this ligament in the center, which provides stability. So when it's torn, in the proper indication, ACL reconstruction is required. One of the ways to reconstruct the ACL is using a different part of the body called the patellar tendon. That's this tendon here. What we do is we make a small incision here in order to harvest this graft. We use the patellar tendon and a little bit of bone above and a little bit of bone below. And then we pass that through the tibia in order to recreate this new ligament and secure it with screws. Another option is to make a smaller incision and use a person's hamstring graft. The hamstring is a little easier. It's all soft tissue. There's no bone involved. The disadvantage, though, is that in about 35% of cases, the hamstring doesn't all grow back. And so that could be an issue for some people. Some studies suggest that the failure rate is a little bit higher. That's really a surgeon preference, I find. I personally prefer the patellar tendon over the hamstring. Another option is to use the quadriceps tendon, which does have one aspect of it involving bone, and that has good success rates too. But you have to take part of the person's quadriceps, so it can affect their ability to bend and straighten. And then there's also the option of allograft tissue, which is essentially tissue that is donated from another person. The advantage of that is that there's no incision, there's no graft taken from the body, it's from someone else. The disadvantage is multifold. One is that the quality of the tissue is not going to be the same as the patient's healthy tissue. Another is that because there's a small risk of contamination, the failure rate's a little bit higher. Studies have also shown that in patients under the age of 25, it's not very effective and the failure rate's pretty high. And so I won't do the ACL reconstruction unless the patient is over the age of 30 using an allograft. Most important thing is to talk to your surgeon and get an understanding of what the options are and together make an informed decision.